Hello, everybody. My name is Malorik, and welcome back to another Mind Vlog. I just kind of wanted to show you guys some things. The new Minecraft launcher, which looks pretty interesting. You don't have that format where you can change everything again. That's gotten moved up here for the switching accounts, things like that. And over here, you have your news, your skins, settings, launch options, which you used to have over here in this corner, which you would pull up the profile and then you would change all that. So that's something new. And then you got this little thing here, which looks like it's got some things for realms, little bits of news and things like that. Looks like you can change your language too. It's either Mandarin or Cantonese. Nihongo. So that's cool, right? I mean, why wouldn't it be cool? So let's go ahead and start this up. I do have the latest version, so we don't have to wait for any kind of loading screens or anything. I do beg your pardon for having the entire thing and showing off all of my nerddom here. But I just kind of wanted to show you the new things that they have on Minecraft. And in order to show you the first part, I captured my whole desktop. So you're going to see all this stuff down here. You can tell what programs I'm using to record this and what's going on in the background. But, you know, hey, if that helps you in some way, I'm happy to help. So I'm going to go into my new world that I made rather recently. And this is where I've been doing most of my vlogs. So you can notice that I can turn and it doesn't lag as much as it used to. That's because the new launcher settings and the new settings for the Java that's running in the background to keep this program up has been updated as well to be more streamlined. excuse me. And I did have some wonderful little melons and stuff here last time. I just harvested them not too long ago. I do play this in my off time, and it's not exclusively for the broadcast, because I do like playing normally as well. And since this is my most recent world, I like kind of playing here. I got to build more of this. But I also wanted to show you some nifty tricks and codes and things down here. Bloop. So, and since all of this has to be done with cheats on, because otherwise it's not going to do what I want it to do, and you wouldn't see anything, and it would be absolutely terrible. But we're going to go way, way down. And I'll show you exactly what's going to happen. I'll see you there. What the fudge? Where you come from? Huh? Yeah, you stay in there. No, stay in there. There we go. Okay. Without any more interruptions, I hope. I hope. This area is well lit. So, okay. First off, you want to pull this up by hitting the slash key with the question mark, which is the forward slash. Yeah, the forward slash. So, you'll use forward slash to do everything that I'm about to show you. So, say you want to give yourself an item. I'll give myself some torches. Torch. 64. If you're not sure what you're looking for, you can type in part of it and hit the tab key, and it'll come up with this little bit right here where it says Minecraft colon torch. And then the next number that you put in is going to be how many. You can only hold a stack of 64, so you can't go over that number, but you can always go back into it and hit the up arrow, and it will pull up the last thing that you did. So now I have 64 torch. Let's just go place these around here real quick to make sure exactly that we don't have any more buttholes that just decide to pop up. Don't ask. I'm actually succeeding at being PC today, and I'm just going to keep running with it if I can. So, there we go. There, we got light everywhere. And now here, I'm going to start something interesting. Let's start it from right here. Okay. So you're going to see me do some things. And if I die, I'm going to respawn at that point. But that's not entirely the point of what I'm doing. I want to be on that side of the room. Hang on. Right here is as good as any. Okay. Now see what I've done. You have two coordinates now. I mean, you could always hit... Hang on. You can always hit F3 and get exactly where you are, and you can write this stuff down. You can see your X, Y, Z, the block that you're on, which is what the coordinates that we're using. Don't worry about the chunk or facing north, biome, or any of that other stuff. But what you really want is block, which is the... That's 6. Skip the space. 7. That's the 8th thing down that's actually readable. So, debug pi, shift. Oh, yeah, you can do that. Sorry, I haven't used this very often, so I'm going to close that because I'm not going to use all of the debug stuff. So let's just do fill. So you can't hit tab for this. You'll have to do fill. There's a space there. I can't have that. Fill from minus. Now that's important. You have to have the minus in there or it's going to do something somewhere far off from wherever the fuck you are. Well, there goes my PC rating. And it will be absolutely terrible. So actually, let's go down to 9. Yeah, let's go down to 9. And 216. And the other coordinates would be minus 130. 15. Up, go up a little bit from there, from where we were. And 186. And what we're going to do is fill it with air. Watch this. This is going to be cool. Poof. It's gone. All of it's gone. Do you see that? Everything just disappeared. In this area. And then all that stuff fell from the ceiling because it was being held up by the blocks underneath it. How cool is that? Now you have a cool little area cleared out underground just for you. You can always show everybody else that too. I really wanted to show you that because it's been a helpful tool, especially when making very large structures. And I can actually show you what I mean here real quick. Safe quit. Single player. Thickets. Oh, Antilia. Oh, shoot. I think I might be lost on Antilia. So don't remember where... Yeah, I'm lost. Crap. I have a really big world here. Desert's definitely the wrong way. Or was it? I don't remember. Oh no. Oh no! I've lost my kingdom. I mean, it's only me that lives there, so it's not really a kingdom, but I've lost my kingdom. You know, it's the little things. I know it's around water, but it's not in the desert. It's in this kind of area. Well, it's a little bit in desert. Shoot, I don't know. It's like in between, because I made it in two biomes. It was right on the edge. So I feel like if I follow this for a little bit, I might find it. I'm going to poke around real quick. And I'll... If I find it, you'll see it. If not, I will apologize in a little bit. But otherwise, I will see you in a few minutes. Activating jump cut. I think... I think I found something. Please tell me you're one of the villages with the teleport. I don't see a teleport block. Oh no! Oh! Crap. Okay, it's gonna take me way too long to find what I'm actually looking for. What I'm looking for is... I'll show you exactly what I'm looking at. And you can only get this and use it in creative mode on the computer. I'm not sure if they added this kind of functionality to the PlayStation and Xbox versions, but it's command block. Now, this little guy right here. There we go. So this guy here with a button, because you just put him down. Oops. Put him down. And then you can edit what it does. Now, I use these to make teleporters. So if you want to make like a game and stuff, that's what I would use. By saying teleport. And you don't have to worry about the slash because it is a command. At P, which would be the person that touches the button because they're the closest person. You can see that right here. Use at P to target nearest player, or R to random player, or at A for all players and E for all entities. Now, an interesting thing about this is that you have impulse, unconditional, and needs redstone. Only play with these if you know more about this than I do. And that's not a whole lot that you have to know before you get past my point. So I'm still a kind of a player more than a creator. So I will play more on this than I will actually build codes and things like that. Because I'm not very good at coding, but I would like to get better. And this is a good platform to start on. And then you put in those like coordinates from before, say 1, 15, 60, and 107. Done. Okay. And then all you need is love. That's not wholly true. You actually need something to work it. A button to work. Buttons work. You have to crouch to put the button on the goddamn block. God damn it. Teleporto. And P to 115. 60. Most upper world is 60 or greater on a normal large biome map. Anything below that, you're going to put yourself in rocks and you'll die instantly. And it'll be messy. 106. Okay. Then we put a button on it. And we press the button. Whoa! I'm in water! So yeah. That's how I get lost. Again. And I didn't pick the coordinates down on where I was in the first place. Joy. But you can also just teleport yourself to... Ah, screw it. Let's go to the center. 60. Zero. Yeah. 60 blocks above. Actually, let's go 60... 9 blocks above. Quit laughing. Arg. Teleport. Melorik. Yeah. So this is exactly Dick O'Clock. Actually, I wonder. One, 70 at 24 of 6. Oops. Teleporto. Well, all right. Yeah. I'm just getting myself more lost. Minus. Oh, that seems very close. So, yeah, I just keep getting myself more lost. So let's... I'll show you something that's... Crap. I really like that one. This has one of my biggest things. I mean, you can kind of see it in the picture there. It's actually a giant library modeled after the one that's in this map here, which is much, much bigger. If I knew exactly... Well, actually, I probably do. This map was not made by me. As you can see, this is gigantic. This map was made by a collection of people. And I picked it up because I really like the Toho series. It's really fun. You can see I have a indicator on which way to F and go, so I don't get more lost than I already am. Oh, hells, I'm actually already lost. My voice is cracking. Ah! There's a little boat. Hold on, I'm gonna get us there. I'll get us there. There's a little Matsuri festival. Just kind of got to follow the path. Nah, you can see the back of the village here. This place is really cool. And they got like little rice fields and stuff. Just thought I'd kind of show you that there. But our destination is going to be this way. I sort of have an idea of where I'm going, so do bear with me. This is where I wanted to show you. I forgot that I had a bed that I slept in. There. This. Wait for it. There it is. This giant mansion came from our dimension. God, it's a pretty house. But it's not the house itself. That's all that interesting. I mean, as you can see, it's kind of dilapidated. It's missing some parts. But what's really interesting is what's inside. Books. Lots of books, right? Wait till you see this. Okay. You haven't seen nothing yet. little play place. But what I want to show you is right in here. Right in here. This. There we go. Come on, load in. Load up the back wall. There we go. This place was my inspiration to build the place that I was building before. And oh my god, it's huge. So huge. I mean, it is so big that the way that I have my render distance right now just doesn't cover it. And then you have all of this right here. Look at that. How cool is that? I'm going to look for the people that built this because I got it off of a YouTube channel. And I'm going to link them over in the bottom so you guys can see just how extensive this map is, because they'd made like a 2-3 hour video, something like that, for like showcasing all of this. And I downloaded the map off of that. And originally there were teleports and things like, oh, where is it? Nope. It's back on this side, I think. Oh, that's the Starbucks. Dude. Oh, it was right next to it. This right here. If you flew right in here. I don't have all the codes and things to make it work again. But this took you to an entirely different map, which was a new world. It wasn't in this map. It loaded up an entirely new world. Like another server. So that was really cool. I love this design on the ceiling, and all of this was inspired by the Toho series. The Scarlet Devil, which I think was the 6th game in the series. But yeah, this inspired me to build some pretty cool things. And when building something this big, using those codes really helps kind of clear out the area so you can build up. I also use this same building technique, which you put light behind this little bit right here. And then you have your books, more light, books, light, books. But it was incredible to watch them working on this. It was so amazing. I cannot give them enough props as it is. I mean, just the idea of building this entire thing in itself. I mean, it was a bunch of people that worked at, and I may be just one person, but I like building really big things. And this is no exception. I wish I could have been there to help, but I was not. It was done by the time that I had found it, but I downloaded it, and so I could pretty much explore Gensokyo, which is the entire world that that's based in. These are the other ones, because you have this place here, the Lunar Moon, Makai, and this is a thing where I had cheats going, because this and a couple other ones are, oh, I guess those ones aren't on here anymore. But this one is specifically for the Toho mod. It doesn't have anything to do with everything else. And I have 2 copies of this map, and I don't know why. But yeah. We'll go back to my world. So I hope you kind of enjoyed that little bit there. If there are other kind of things that you wish to see, like if you want to see me do some more mods or anything like that in the Mine vlog, or to show other kind of maps and things like that, or what else you could do with Minecraft as far as programming, anything like that, let me know down in the comments below. But I'm gonna leave that here for now, and I Thank you guys so much for watching. Remember to like this episode if you enjoyed the content that I have provided today. And do subscribe so you can see the next Mind Vlog when it comes out. And don't forget the annotations on the ending part there that will send you to some of my other videos that I've been working on. One is the Ruby series, which I'm doing just for the sake of having fun and playing something that's a part of a series that Monty Oom created. I've been a fan of his since Dead Fantasy 1, and I've been watching his work throughout the years. It's all too soon that he left us, and it's just kind of all around, you know, left a creative hole over at Rooster Teeth that they're doing really well to fill in with their talent, but I don't think there's anybody quite like Monty. He just had such an imagination, but I'm glad they're continuing his series in his honor. And yeah, do give that a look. And then I also am doing a retro series for Super Mario RPG Legend of the Seven Stars, so you can give that a click too. Sorry I ran a little long on the mumbling and bubbling there about my fandom. So, again, I will see you in the next installment. Farewell for now.